go through how to create a conference and how to use a conference. These are conference bridges, which are conference calls for groups. And what we're going to do is we're going to set them up under conferences in the portal, and we're going to go to add a conference. And then here we're going to give it a name, something descriptive so that we know which one this was, like a conference on Wednesdays. If, let's say you have a weekly meeting, that you want to go ahead and set up the conference and everybody will call into it. That's when a description for that type of meeting. And then the type we're going to leave at the default, which is always going to be dedicated conference bridge. Own conference bridges are a different configuration, and that we'll go over at in another section. Next step is to add an extension number for the conference. The conference is going to get an extension number so we can direct numbers from the inventory to it, or users from within the network can call the extension and join the conference. And the conference extension number is going to be something sequential with the extension numbers that you are already using for your extensions. For example, if you're using the 100 series extensions, 100, 101, 102, you want to use something like maybe a 300 or 400 for your conference bridge to make sure it's three sets of numbers. If you're using three sets of numbers for your extension numbers, if you're using four sets of numbers, then you want to use the same when creating a conference bridge. The leader pin and the participant pin are the two different pins that will be prompted for to enter into the conference. One will be a leader and will have the options in the conference as a leader, and you can have the leader required to be there before any other participants can join. These can be both the same if you don't want to have differences between leaders and participants. They can both have the same pin number. The maximum number of participants to start is how many people need to be at the conference before you can start it or before it will start. I like to set this at 2. So there are usually 2. So that way there's usually a leader and a participant at least to start. But you can set this to 1 or any number that you like. The next fields are options such as required a leader to start. So one would have to enter the leader pin first and then the meeting can start. Prompt all participants for their names. This is going to prompt everybody to say their name. And then it's going to, if you check on the next box, announce them as they enter and leave our conference. So once this is configured, just go ahead and hit save, and your conference will be set up.